A warm day today. Some areas pushing near 70 degrees at these mid-afternoon temperatures. 68 here in the metro, 71 Port Gibson, 70 at Fayette. Temperatures tonight are going to be on the mild side. Southeast winds have been gusting during the day today, as high as 20 to 25 miles an hour in many areas around the region. And lows for tonight are going to be down only in the 50s, with these southeast winds continuing to gust. And these are the current wind gusts right now, 15 to 20 miles an hour up towards the Delta. 16 is what the wind is gusting here in the metro area. The clouds cleared out today. Bright sunshine took over, so it was actually a very nice day, warm by late December standards, but the clouds will begin to increase over the area tonight. There is the chance of maybe a couple passing showers overnight and during the day tomorrow, as moisture begins to return back into the area ahead of our next storm, which will be moving in here on New Year's Eve. So these are the lows for tonight. Again, area-wide, temperatures in the 50s, 55 in the metro. Temperatures may hold in the upper 50s along the river counties, and a little bit cooler off to the east. Numbers may slip into the lower 50s. Tomorrow, another warm day. Southeast winds will be gusting between 15, 20 miles an hour. Mostly cloudy skies and temperatures in the upper 60s to near 70. So here is that big storm system, which is out to the west right now across Arizona and New Mexico. And this is going to be a very potent storm system that's going to wind up across the region. Now, this energy is going to kick out to the northeast, but another area of low pressure is going to develop here across Texas, and that is going to send a strong cold front through our area, and that's going to be the focal point for showers and thunderstorms. Some of those storms could be on the strong side Thursday night. So here's the future cast again. This is the overnight. Clouds will begin to increase, thicken up. There could be a couple spot showers down southeast of Metro Jackson. And then during the day tomorrow, gusty winds, cloudy skies, and then the temperatures are going to be moving up to near 70. There could be a few passing showers during the day. It's not going to be a washout, but just be prepared. There could be a few showers around tomorrow. And then as we head into Thursday morning, here's that area of low pressure organizing back out to the southwest. This is the front that's going to be slowing down to a crawl. So we're talking heavy rainfall just off to our northwest from North Texas, Arkansas, through portions of Tennessee. These areas could receive upwards of 2 to 5 inches of rainfall. And then here comes the system as it begins to wind up Thursday. Now, there could be a few showers during the day on Thursday as we head towards the afternoon, watching for thunderstorms that will begin to increase from the south. Watching these cells right here, because these could produce some severe weather. We're talking gusty winds and maybe a spin-up tornado. But there's the system organizing back out to the west of us. That's going to blow through here Thursday night. Now, again, strong thunderstorms are possible. Still looking like the highest threat of that is going to be south of Metro Jackson, south and east of Metro Jackson. Now, this is where you can see the strongest wind energy. That's going to be right along the front. So we're talking about a line of thunderstorms moving through, and those thunderstorms could have some gusty winds with them. But out ahead of that, there could be some severe weather, strong thunderstorms to our east across Florida into Alabama. So this front moves through Thursday night. New Year's Day, we're left with cooler conditions. Sunny skies will be developing, and temperatures right around 60. Then we have another surge of cool air that's going to come in for the weekend, lowering those highs down to near 50. So right now, the storm impacts are relatively low. Flooding and hail, not a big threat. Damaging winds, a little bit of a higher threat with that line coming through. Tornado threat, again, low in the Jackson metro area. Again, the highest threat of that would be down to our south and to our east. So that's what we're highlighting right here, from Brookhaven to Macomb to Bassfield to the southeast, would have the highest threat of those spin-up tornadoes. Again, there's a chance of maybe some gusty winds, isolated severe weather across the Jackson metro area. The rainfall, not going to be too much of a concern here, but look out to the west. These rainfall totals 2 to 5 inches, but that line is going to be blown through here pretty quickly. So in the metro area, 1/2 inch to 1 inch of rainfall is a pretty good bet around here. A breezy night, mostly cloudy skies, a few showers possible through the night, 55. Southeast wind gusting to 20. Then tomorrow, 70, mostly cloudy, warm and breezy. A passing shower is possible. Those winds still gusting between 20 and 25 miles an hour. And there's your 7-day forecast again. Cooler weather moves in for New Year's Day, and we're going to stay on the cool side through the weekend, the first weekend of 2021, and then sunshine and temperatures near average as we start the first full week of 2021.